Hello everyone, CrystalFissure here. Welcome to another part of everyone's favourite game, kind of, Speed Freaks. And today we're doing the final two levels, of hard mode. And do they reflect hard mode as a whole? Yes. Definitely yes. Just have a look. Here we are. Grand Rapids. This is the... yes, perfect start. This is the mother of all difficult levels, at least this is Beamer's home track, SDGT Racing Team, it says up there, I don't know what that means, could be random, but yeah, this level, is difficult, for the most part, but it's still possible to actually, do well in this level, without failing too much. It just depends on your technique. It depends on what you do. Now, I'm not playing very well. I'm a bit rusty. It's been a few days since I last recorded. But there's definitely tricks in order to help your progress a lot easier. For example, that. There we go. And I'll have to utilize that trick against Beamer when I verse Beamer, which I'm sure you guys are looking forward to a lot because it is quite an epic race, I think. But, yeah, it's a very, you know, what level do I say doesn't look good in this game? I was about to say this is another nice looking level, but I mean, you know, it speaks for itself. This is a brilliantly designed level, incredibly tough, but also just really beautiful. You know, once again, look at that waterfall up there. You know, they just, Speed Freaks, the Funcom, the Irish developers, they just love their waterfalls, don't they? I mean, maybe it's an Irish thing. Maybe waterfall represents leprechauns or something like that. Who knows? Or maybe I just sounded incredibly racist. But whatever. Anyway, so, you know, the abundance of waterfalls is welcome. Oh, there's another one. Grand Rapids, I guess that's why it's called. But, yeah, really awesome level. Oh, shit. Apparently, according to Mr. Oblivion LP, if you do a sharp turn, you're able to actually avoid getting hit by those. And I've done that a few times by luck, but also sometimes they eventually run out if you get far enough ahead. So that's kind of what I bank on. Oh shit! Now, number two got in front. Now I don't think there's any way of avoiding that. I'd safe to say you pretty much have to just jump all the way out of the way. So, damn you, Monica. I'll get my revenge on you somehow, damn it. That's one of the biggest risks of the level, is that just because, okay? Oh, shit. I was about to cross and then, look what happened. I get crossed by Monica. Typical Monica, isn't it? Love you, Monica. Just kidding. I don't like you, Monica. Alright, anyway, look at the sun up there, sunset. Really cool colour sky, by the way. And they've reused those, you see that in the hard, in medium mode, medium mode difficulty, secret tracks or whatever. Oh, no. Oh, you know, you could never part of the Let's Play without falling in the water. It's part of everyone's childhood who play this game. Yeah, I love the fact that there's all these... hot air balloons like in the sky randomly. It's like, yeah, that's awesome. Okay, so got it. Yes, excellent. Yeah, oh, that was pretty slick. Sometimes it just depends. Sometimes you're really lucky when the angle that you turn in, do you know what I mean? Other times it just doesn't it doesn't suit. And oh shit, thank you Ratchet 5, you bastard. I just got a message from him and it caused me not to concentrate. There we go. Okay, fifth lap. Got to concentrate. Oh, no. Okay, come on. Uh-oh, yes, sucked in, Monica. Sucked in, and as we finish off this beautiful level, I'm going to play it safe and go like that. And then, oh, shit, I'm panicking. Uh-oh. Oh my god. Yes! Fuck yeah. Sorry for the swearing, but hell yeah. Okay, I shall be back. You won't see it in the recording. Okay, see you. We'll do the next race now. And we are back. Okay, so now we're on to the final level of the game. Not the final level ever played. The final level ever played is hard mode, this type of level, I think. But the final level, actually, like new level. But this is the final campaign, so to speak, level. And it is called What's it called again? It's something Isle, I think. Sunset Isle. Now, what a conclusion. Excuse my... Wait a minute. Put the microphone a bit closer. Okay, there we go. Excuse my concentration. I may not talk as much, only because this level... Actually, I got to concentrate a bit. This level is incredibly difficult. You know, it's got a very... Like, it seems it's like it's even far... Oh, shit. There we go. No. Okay, that completely glitched. This is a mini shortcut that I find very useful. I don't know why no one else goes through. It's kind of obvious. It's out in the open. And then... Okay. Oh, crap. Great start. This level is just... merciless. Like, it's almost like the controls are made more difficult and clunky with this level. Do you know what I mean? Like, it really... Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't... Crap. Yeah, it doesn't help you out at all. It definitely is reflective of the game's hard mode. Obviously, this would never be an easy mode. It's just a very tongue-twisty level. Like, this is a... You can do that as well. There we go, this is a shortcut, which I don't even think is much of a shortcut, except I actually seem to do a pretty good job there. Now, if you turn, go like this, you actually get quite a good boost around this corner. It's almost like, yeah, it goes faster, as I said before. Yes, got Tabitha. But yeah, concentration-wise, be on your best concentration/behavior. No joking around, this would not be a part for guest commentators by any means, just because, well, you know... It's just difficult. Okay. Oh, shit. That bit is just such a fucking annoyance. Oh, shit. See, look at that. Third. And actually, in between the two levels, I actually had to do something, and then I had to speak to Andrew, and we ended up recording part of Bug's Life. So, yeah, I've been talking for, like, about 40 minutes. So, I'm starting to get a bit of a sore throat. fucking had no luck. Sore throat for weeks. Anyway, let's get this bastard. There we go. Now, there's a good trick in order to... Nah, didn't do it. Sometimes if you can turn and then get enough sort of drift across the side, you can kind of turn around that area much easier, but that didn't work for me. Yeah, look at how bright this level is. Like, it's such a bright level, and the color of, you know, sunset, of course. Just such a... Another waterfall, look at that. Thank you, Speed Freaks, for your admiration of waterfalls. I mean, good on them. You know, waterfalls are awesome. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Yes, avoided that. Okay. See, I don't know what way to go down. The other way is kind of clunky, but then this way, if you can get through straight, you're pretty much all set. There we go. I did the dodge thing that Mr. Oblivion taught me. Thank you, Mr. Oblivion LP, you wonderful Danish man. Okay. Well, no. Oh, it didn't even matter. Great. Ready if he gets in front? She gets in front, and she's dead. Suck it. That was actually a pretty calculated attack. I'll say that. I did actually concentrate. Whoa. Oh, fuck you, Monica. Pain in the ass. Okay, wait. Damn it. There we go. I have to slow down a bit there just to prevent... Yeah, sometimes, yeah, as I did... I think it was in... What level was it? One of the levels. I think it was... Yeah, I think... That's right. I think it was, Oh, shit. Oh, no, not again. Oh, and that kind of helped. As I did in skate park, slowing down around that big, confusing corner can actually really help you. So, alright, I'm going to... Nah, didn't hit her. Damn it. We're on lap 4, by the way. The intensity has been ramped up. I remember as a kid, I used to get nervous on this level because it would be so stressful. Like, literally. Wait, ready? Oh, shit. You know, oh, my... That actually helped. That actually helped. Wow. Good on them. And look, you see that bridge at the top there? I wish you'd go up there. That'd be cool. Shit. Okay, if you look at the map, you look for me, even though you can't actually tell me. Where am I? Oh, that's right. Barely anywhere. Like, yes. Oh, number 2 didn't stop either. Damn you, number 2. Damn you, number 3. Okay. Alright. Okay, come on. There you go. I let go of the accelerator just to get a bit of, get a bit of traction around that corner, because if you fall in the lava, say goodbye to... Yes. No. Actually, I'm gonna let her get in front. Watch this, ready? No. Oh, damn it. I actually wanted to get in front right now. Okay, there we go. Oh, she didn't step on it. No, woohoo. She just cheered. That's not good. And I lost my train of thought. Okay. Now, it's time to concentrate. Ready? Here we go. Dun, dun, dun. Great music, though. Great music. It really does suit. But yeah, nervousness ramped up right now, both in this game and then also as a child. It got those nostalgic memories of nostalgia. That's what I've got. Nostalgic memories of nostalgia. Okay. There we go. Excellent. Here we go. This is going to round it off. I'm actually quite a bit in front. Good times ahead, everyone. Good times ahead. If I can win. Come on. Yes. Okay, here we go. Here we go. And oh my god. This is a great moment in Fisher's life. Done. I did it. Now, I'm kind of subduing my excitement because I don't want my parents to know I'm recording a Let's Play when I should be studying for a maths exam. Anyway, let's go to that. There we go. Just put a little slight personal insight into what's going on under the household of Fisher. But yeah, let's just load this screen and finish off. And then we get a verse beamer. And I'm scared. And confused. No, I'm kidding. I'm just scared because Beamer is a scary being, and you will see him in his essence shortly. Here we go. Yeah, man, psych, man, yeah. And oh, the two girls, Tabitha, Monica, destroyed. Anyway, there we go. Hard league beaten. Hope you enjoyed that part, guys. I shall see you in the next part when we verse Beamer. Look forward to it.